Hello, everybody. Binga Olatunji here. Business management and finance is what we'll be looking at today. And we want to review and overview the syllabus, the expectation of the institute for everyone that want to become a member. Business management and finance, which we popularly call BMF. What you need to know before you can pass this course, and it forms the foundation of you becoming a member of the institute. So what is the expectation of the institute? How can you easily pass it? And what do you need to know? And these are the things that we want to go into. And BMF, business management and finance, forms actually the foundation of being a professional. So it's a topic, it's a course that we cannot overlook. More importantly, that is, it has three broader courses in it. Business is a very large topic, management is a very large topic, and finance is a course on its own. So when we combine it together, we'll see that business management and finance as a topic, we must not overlook it. So what are the expectations of the institute? First of all, the course is broken into four parts: the business processes and environment is one, and it carries 25% of the syllabus. So you must know business processes and how to scan through business environment. We are going to go into all this in details. Then the role of professional accountant in business and society. So the institute want you to know what will be your role at the end of the day as a business manager in the society, and how can you easily carry out and discharge your duty. How's management and organizational behavior? 35% of it. The last one, that I just mentioned, the role of professional accountant in business and society, is 10%. Management and organizational behavior is 35%. So that deals with the ethics of the business, ethics, personal ethics, how should we behave, how should we carry ourselves, and the like. Management and organizational behavior. Then last but not the least is the role of finance. Finance is very important, and many people look at the role of accountant and the role of finance, they look alike, but actually they are different. Finance and accounting, they are different, and that is why in schools we study them differently. Okay, so let us quickly look at the breakdown of topics before we go into them in depth. So the syllabus, first of all, we want you to know the business organization and stakeholders. When you are in an organization, what are the stakeholders that you must relate with? Who are those people that you must ensure are satisfied with your professional behavior and your professional competence? Two, business and organizational structure. It's important for you to understand structure, how business works, how organizational structure works. Then organizational culture in business. Every organization has its own unique culture. So we want to introduce you to organization culture and in business generally. The external environment, how external environment influences our business endeavor. We want you to understand it in depth and have an in-depth knowledge. Then we'll be talking about financial management. Financial management. How should we manage the finance of our organization? Then we'll talk about sources of finance. How can we source out funds for our organization and business? We are going to talk and discuss in depth the financial mathematics. The financial mathematics. So we'll be talking about annuity there and the like. Then we'll be talking about investment decision one and investment decision two. So investment decisions, business appraisers and the like will be looked at. We are going to go into it in depth. Then we'll be talking, chapter 10, we'll be talking about professional ethics in accounting and business. Professional ethics in accounting and business. We'll look at management and leadership. Management and leadership, because as a business manager, as an accountant, you are a leader in your own capacity. And to build up that capacity, we must ensure that even as a student, you begin to learn leadership and how to manage events, how to manage businesses. Then motivation. We are going to talk about motivation. How can we motivate others around us? How can even ourselves be motivated? What are the sources of motivation and the like, and management theories that surrounds it? Also, we will talk about team, formation of team members and the like. We are going to talk about communication in business. This is very important for business leaders to be able to communicate properly as business owners, as business managers and the like. So different forms of communication will be looked at, report writing, business reports as the last, but not the least topic, verbal communication, how to hold meetings and the like. These are the breakdown of the syllabus. Business management and finance. We are going to go into detail of the topics that we've mentioned, but why, what is the aim of this course? What is the aim? What does the Institute have in mind when we are talking about business management and finance? Basically, the Institute wants you to understand and be a professional when we are talking about the market in which your organization is, the financial market, the organization itself, laying the sound professional life for you. So it's a topic that talks about and deals with the purpose of the organization and wants you to understand the purpose of finance, the purpose of business, the purpose of management, issues that could surround business management, finance in form of ethical issues, how corporate organizations are governed, the social responsibility of corporate organization, and last but not the least, business sustainability, environmental sustainability and the like. So these are part of what the Institute wants you to really understand. So BMF is broken into parts and link other courses as you continue your journey to become a member. So you'll see, if you look at this diagram, let me broaden it so that you can see it clearly more. I think you can see it more now. Okay, so BMF is like the basis of a lot of important courses that you are going to still study. So it's interlink corporate strategic management and ethics, which we normally call CSME. It's interlink PM, that is performance management. It's interlinks PSA, that is public sector accounting and finance. And these three actually go further to enable you to understand strategic financial management, SFM, and last but not the least, case study. Case study. I like the call very well, and maybe later I'll let you know why I like case study. Okay, so let us move on. Business management and finance is a strategic course, and basically when you know this, how are you going to know that you understand this course, business management and finance? At the end of the day, you must know the principle of management and management theories, theory X, theory Y, and the like, and a lot of other promulgators and contributors into the field of management. You must know it, and also at the end of the day, you must be able to understand business ethics, business considerations, structure, leadership, conflict management, conflict resolution, communication, both verbatim, both oral, holding a meeting, emailing, and the like. You must know how to source out fund at the end of the day. So it's a very practical course. You must know how to source out fund and sources of fund that you can look out for to enhance your business and to move the business in which you are a leader forward. Also, you must understand the function of finance and its relationship to other aspects and departments and functions within the organization. You must know where value is actually being created in your organization and how to create value. Your corporate objective, you must understand it and become crystal clear on how to study and understand corporate objective, stakeholders that you must relate with, and the shareholders, how to relate with them and handle them. You must, at the end of the day, you must understand investment policy, investment appraiser, not mismatching funds between the long-term financing and short-term financing. These are the indicators that you've actually understood at the end of the day business management and finance. You must know how to acquire investments and how to retain investments, how to appraise investments, how to utilize and manage working capital and the like, how to plan and how to take business decision. So if you are yet to subscribe to GJ's Associates channel, please go and subscribe right away. Click the notification button. Like us, GJ's Associates, we are value to life, we are value to your business. So in details now, the outline of the course. Don't forget, we've earlier mentioned it and we're still going to revise it. So as students of business management and finance, BMF, at the end of the day, must understand the nature of business, types and objectives of business, must be able to explain all this and understand it rather. The difference between sole proprietorship, partnership, limited liability company, whether public or private, NGOs, that is non-governmental organization, must be able to understand how to form alliances and also how private sector organization actually works, and cooperative society. We must also learn to identify and explain various business functions. How does HR will work and operate within an organization must be able to know how procurement departments relates to finance, how sales relates to marketing and the like. These are many more we are going to know. We must be able at the end of the day to explain and differentiate and clarify between economic activity based profession, vocation, employment, business and the like. We must be able to understand all this and distinguish between them. We must be able to state the merits and demerits of different occupations. Still under business processes and environments, we must study and be able to explain business characteristics and purposes of having a different forms of culture and structure, the centralized, the decentralized, the hybrid, that is matrix and mixed network of organization and virtual arrangement, especially now that we are talking about virtual and everything has gone into the air. We say virtual, so we must be able to understand how our organization is formed, its uniqueness and organizational structure, also the disadvantages and the advantages of being a centralized organization, operating decentralization, virtual arrangement, or working from home, if we can use the word network of business as a structure, midst of all this, which we call matrix. Also, under business process and an environment, we must be able to understand and explain globalization as a form of business environment and international business, macroeconomics, national environment, microeconomics, and our direct market and industry in which we operate for, operate in, and how they are interrelated and influence our business sources. Stakeholders, like we mentioned before, must be able to understand influences of different stakeholders within our organization and how to respond and manage them. We must be able to explain the concept of environmental scanning. What is environmental scanning? That is, we must be able to peep in into what is going on around us as a business organization and bring something tangible out of it in form of strategy for our organization. Then the part B of our syllabus will be talking about the role of professional, that is you, in business and in the society. So we are going to talk about explaining from the perspective of public interest, and as accountants, we are holders of public interest. Please don't forget that, the role of professional accountant in business and society. Then we'll talk about basic principle of ethics and importance of professional ethics to professional accountant. Then we will talk and look at the C part, which talks about management of our organization and organizational behavior. We may marvel that, really, as organization, does organization have behavior? Really? But the truth of the matter is, as organization, we have our structures, and organizations usually behave in a specific pattern. So we need to understand patterns of organizational behavior. So basically, we'll be talking about basic management function. And don't forget, when we're talking about management, you are part of the management. Okay? So we are going to talk about various definition of management. Don't forget, we say management is a course on its own. Then we are going to identify and explain types of management skills, like we mentioned leadership, I've mentioned communication. These are skills that management, as a manager, must be able to possess. You must be able to explain and know how to plan, how to organize, how to control units and business, how to coordinate. And these are keywords in the definition of what we called management. So we are going to look at it also. Then we are going to look at, apart from directing and supervision, which is part of the definition of management, we are going to be able, and we must be able to identify and explain various management roles. Then we go into part two of management and organizational behavior. Then we'll be looking at individuals' behavior, we'll be looking at management's mindset, we'll be looking at organizational perspective and behavior. So under it, we'll be talking about nature and significance of formal and informal organization. We'll be talking about the role of organizational culture and organizational structure. We'll be talking about relationship between leadership and management. Oh, let me ask you a question. Do you think they are the same? Okay. We are going to answer that question. We'll be looking at the states of individual's behavior and how it influences the organizational behavior and culture as a whole. We must be able to identify and explain conflict management. Know when conflict may likely arise and why it may arise, what may trigger it, and to be able to think ahead of various resolution mechanisms that we need to use to handle them. We are going to talk about the nature and significance of team formation. How do we form team? How are teams developed? And how can we manage team? Then we will go on to talk about how to motivate ourselves and how to motivate employees under us, relationship building and the like, and how to ensure productivity. We must be able to state and explain various management theories as regards this, both scientific and otherwise, administrative and the like, and key people that contribute into management theory, like Frank, like Herzberg, and the like. Motivation factor theory and the like, you must be able to understand it critically. Then we go to the communication part of it, in which we'll be talking about elements of communication. How are we going to know that somebody is a communicator and a good communicator? And part of communication too is both verbal and non-verbal, and being a good listener. So we are going to examine this and build up our capacity in this area. Then we will talk about the formal and informal communication within an organization, internal and external communication, and how to handle them. We will talk about methods of business communication. We will talk about barriers to effective communication. And there are really barriers to effective communication. We are going to talk about different communication patterns, processes, and conducts within a meeting, and how to conduct ourselves, comport ourselves, and organize a meeting. We're going to explain basic elements of reporting and report writing. And last but not the least, we are going to talk about electronic communication. Communication basically and generally is a sensitive and important skill that a business manager, a professional accountant, and anybody that wants to further greatly in business must really understand. Then we go to the deep parts of our syllabus. Don't forget, it was broken into four parts. The deep part is about the role of finance, the role of finance, and as accountants, we need to pay attention to all these four aspects And finance is key, is the lifeblood of any organization. So basics of finance and financial market will be looked at. So we'll be talking about source of finance like we talked about, but now maybe on a larger and enlarged scope. We'll be talking about characteristics of different sources of finance and which one will be the best and most appropriate for our needs as organization, so that we will not go into error and mismatch funds with which has their consequences when it happens. We are going to describe the characteristics of financial markets. We are going to talk about the objective of financial management and finance function. What are the expectations of business owners for us when we are hired as finance managers? So we must understand finance function, financial management's objective. So we must be able to explain some keywords and understand them, because all these words are important and they usually put them in letters and agreements. We want to obtain loan and the like. So what's a covenant? What are warranties? What are guarantees? Are they the same, and what are their similarities and differences? How should we manage them? So we are going to learn how to prepare cash budgets using given information and data that will be provided or available in our organization. Two, we are going to talk about investment decision. Then we'll be talking about compounding interest, simple interest, discounting. We'll be talking about annuity. Many people will say annuity, me, I'm still young, annuity is for the old and retired. No, not at all. You must understand annuity. Then we'll talk about present value of annuity. We're talking about sinking funds and amortization. We'll take a look at ARR, that is accounting rate of return, payback period, discounted payback. We'll talk about NPV rather, that is net present value, and we'll talk about IRR, that is internal rate of return. So basically, we've covered the four areas in which our syllabus is broken into, that is business process and environment, the role of professional accountants in business and society, management and organizational behavior, and last but not the least, the role of finance manager. So basically, we want to go into detail of the topics in the syllabus, topics and the coverage of the topics in the syllabus. So chapter one, when we are talking about the business organization and its stakeholder, don't forget we are not talking about shareholders, we say stakeholders. So we are going to look at the types of organization and types of organizational structure. We'll take a look at shareholders, who are the stakeholders. Also, we are going to look at collaboration, how to collaborate with them. Then when we are talking about chapter two, that is business organization and structure, we'll take a look at types of business too, basic concepts of business organization and management structure. We'll look at functional departments within business organization. Then we get to part topic number three, that is the organizational culture in business. We generally look at organizational culture and how it influences the business success. Then chapter four deals with the external environment. So we are going to look at the nature of environmental influences around us, like political, pastoral. We are going to look at legal factor. We are going to look at macroeconomics factor. We are going to look at microeconomics factor, social and demographic factor. We are going to look at technology or technological factor, how it influences and affects our organization and our performance and sources. These are critical success factors that must be looked at. We look at our environmental, that is even the competitiveness within our industry. Then international perspective will be looked at under the external environment. Then when we are talking about chapter 5, that is financial management, we'll be talking about the objective of finance, the stakeholders in finance. We'll be talking about financial management, and the financial management framework will be looked at. Then we move on to chapter 6, which talks about sources of finance. So when we are talking about sources of finance, we will be looking at the long term, we'll be looking at the short term, we'll be looking at how to raise new equity, we'll be looking at how to generate finance externally, we'll be talking about how to use debt capital to finance our organization, convertible bonds, bonds that have warranty and the like attached to them. So that is what we are going to be studying under chapter 6. Then we move on to finance or financial mathematics in chapter 7. Then we'll be talking about simple interest, we'll be looking at compounding interest, and we are going to study annuity. Then we'll be talking about chapter 8, which is about investment decision, and as managers you must be able to decide very well. So we'll be talking about discounting, we'll be talking about NPV, that is net present value, how to calculate it for any project within our organization. We'll be talking about investment appraisal, discounting, the annuity. We'll be talking about IRR, that is internal rate of return. Then we move on to chapter 9, which is the part 2 of investment decision. Then we'll be talking about capital expenditure, that is CAPEX. We'll be talking about investment appraisal, capital budgeting. We'll be talking about accounting rate of return, that is ARR. We mentioned IRR before, internal rate of return. Now we are talking about accounting rate of return, IRR. And last but not the least, under chapter 9, which is investment decision part 2, we'll be talking about payback period. We're talking about payback period and some others that we'll be looking at under investment decision part 2 will be like relevant cost in investment decision, how to compare all these methods with themselves so that we can know which one is better, like comparing IRR with ARR and payback period and the like. I'm making an investment decision that is tangible and worthy of our time and sources. Then we'll be talking about also non-financial consideration that we need to pay attention to, because when we want to make financial investment decision, not everything will be financial. Some may be non-financial, but they are important. Like even though the project has prospects and the like, but let's say for example they are not managing the organization that we want to put money in very well, which is non-financial consideration, then we may lose the capital. So we are going to look at non-financial considerations too in decision making and social and environmental issues that relate to investment decision. Then we'll move on to chapter 10, which talks about professional ethics in accounting and business. And under that, we'll be looking at some fundamental principles of ethical behaviors, the role of regulatory bodies and professional bodies like ICANN. We'll be looking at corporate code of ethics. Like we have fundamental 5 corporate code of ethics as accountants. So we are going to study them. What are those? We're going to study them. We are going to talk about ethical conflict and dilemma. When somebody say, or we observe that somebody is in a dilemma, what does it mean when we're talking about ethics for somebody to be in dilemma? So we are going to look at it in chapter 10. Then we move on to chapter 11, in which we'll be talking about management and leadership. So under management and leadership, we'll be talking about leadership functions, management functions and supervision. We'll be talking about classical theory of management. We'll be talking about other theories of management. We'll be talking about leadership style. We'll be talking about contingency theories. We'll be talking about leadership qualities. And last but not the least, we'll be talking about conflict resolution and how to manage conflicts. Then we'll move on to motivation. And when we're talking about motivation, we'll be talking about the theory of motivation itself. We're talking about the system that surrounds it, and we'll be talking about other concepts of motivation. Then we move on to chapter 13, which talks about teams, that is formation of teams, how to work within team, how to be team player and the like. So under teams, we'll be talking about ourselves as individuals. We'll be talking about our group behavior within business organization. We'll be talking about the teams and the team's role within the organization. We'll be talking about team formation and team development. Then we'll be talking about effective team and ineffective team, how to ensure that we have an effective team and contributors to ineffectiveness among team members will be looked at. Then when we are talking about chapter 14, we'll be talking about communication in business. So what are the contributors to effective communication, effective business messages? We'll talk about and study email, how to compose email very well. What are the do's and don'ts of email? We'll look at video conferencing, just that as we know now that everything has gone virtual. So the knowledge of video conferencing, email, and all these electronic means of communication, they are very key and important to our professional sources. Then last but not the least among the topics is chapter 12. Then we'll be talking about business reports, how to write reports. We'll introduce ourselves basically into report writing, and we'll talk about how to prepare the content of our report, how to write the report itself, and the report in form of business plan, how to write proposals, how to write many other short forms of reports. It's great to have you, and till now, coming up next on Teachings Associate platform is the first topic in business management and finance, and we'll be looking at the business organization and its stakeholders. Great. If you are yet to subscribe, click the subscription button right away. As you can see, you are going to richly be impacted on this platform. So subscribe to us, like us, click notification button. Teachings Associates, we are value to life, we are value to your business, we are value to your professional career. So Teachings Associates, Gbenga Olatunji will be signing off. Don't forget to like us, click the notification button, subscribe to this channel, Teachings Associates, business management and finance. This is the overview of the syllabus and the expectation of the institute towards you. And when we understand all these 15 chapters, we are going to become a business professional. And this is why Teachings Associates is actually making this video, in readiness and in preparation of the full shot of these 15 topics. It's going to be elaborate, and we know it's a contribution that worth it. So join us as we take a look together at the business organization and its stakeholders. So we'll see you in virtual class.